take Rhode Island. I'm gonna throw out the Rhode Island.
Well, now I feel better about losing to him. Anyway,
I haven't heard too much of 808 recently. I know he used to be power ranked. I think he still is probably in his native state. Sheik Luigi, though, interesting. The punish game when Luigi gets that grab is wild. She can do a lot while Luigi is offstage, but in neutral, she needs to watch herself.
Yeah, it's definitely one of those... It's definitely a little more volatile than people think, but I think Sheik definitely wins this matchup for
absolutely.
Sure. I think Sheik's forward air definitely, kind of messes with Luigi a little bit. And offstage, for sure, Sheik annihilates him.
But as we've seen, the punish game can be, I mean, with examples like Elegant, like the punish game with this character can be absolutely insane. So if he gets that one down throw, he's going to be able to tack on a lot of damage. I think what Unknown is going to want to do is not get too antsy on the overcommit. He's already getting stuffed out quite a bit. I'd like to see some maybe empty hop grabs to kind of mix up Luigi. So, you know, give him a little bit of a taste of his own medicine.
Mm-hmm.
Just get Luigi offstage, keep him offstage.
That is exactly how you want to deal with Luigi. I mean, everybody, Luigi, and this is not to make fun about any 1-2-er players or anything, but he is a noob killer, for sure. A noob killer to the core. Luigi is definitely one of those characters that people who aren't too practiced at this game with those two fantastic techs coming out from Unknown.
Reaction time
is just so oppressive and overwhelming to them, and they're like, what do I do? How do I fight this character? But then when you really sit down and you analyze Luigi and you practice, you find where the character suffers, and that is off stage. You want to get him off stage without that jump.
Jersey's also got some good Luigi's. Y'all got James, you got badges.
Yeah, there's badges as well. I play Luigi, I keep some people at bay. He's with my secondary. He's my second. I play the red hat guy instead. But we do have a fair amount of good Luigi's in our area. So Unknown, definitely pretty practiced
Unknown,
in this matchup.
Okay.
Yeah, he does stuff like
he's
that.
He's flashy.
Man.
He's probably him and Law are incredibly flashy.
For sure.
Players. Yeah, I feel like Riz and R Hungry are like a little more basic. They get the job done, but I feel like Unknown and Law just put on a show every time they play. Really, that's all.
Absolutely.
But. So far, Unknown doing really well after that first skip. Now he doesn't really have to go crazy. He can keep Luigi at bay with needles, wait for Luigi to come in. Doesn't have to go too wild.
And this is also where Unknown can really start to take advantage of, and that backer's going to do it. Good trump.
Good trump. You don't hear that too often.
No, you really don't. Not nowadays. One thing that Luigi does kind of suffer in as well is that he does not have good air speed. Not good air mobility. And Sheik kind of does, you know, she can kind of just outmaneuver Luigi as well. In the air is where she can really just sort of play with her food a little bit, just outmaneuver, outspace Luigi, and she has that forward air to deal with him whenever he wants to approach. Forcing Luigi to approach is pretty bad. No, it's pretty good for the Sheik is what I meant to say. It's pretty bad for the Luigi. And then eventually, if he like whips something, you just get him off stage, and then all of a sudden, he can just afford to do this. You know?
Wow, I cannot believe both of these nuts.
Yeah.
So,
gets the GTX to force him back on.
This Luigi playing like he knows he's about to lose his life to the Grim Reaper in about 20
back
days.
Air? Wow, the raw, powerful back air going to do it, taking game one against Unknown, 808.
This Luigi has been in the Olympics. This guy has been at the Olympic Games. He did not skip leg day. This man is out here. Look at that.
Did not skip leg day.
He didn't, dude.
Yeah, this isn't the Olympic Games.
He's an athlete. You know how many sports he plays? Basketball, baseball.
The metal version of soccer
Mushroom
Kingdom
That's
plays.
That's brutal too. You could die.
Yeah, you could die in that
game.
You
get electrocuted.
Dude. Yeah. What? I mean, it's like what game? You want to know how to bump up soccer? You want to know how to make soccer interesting besides watching people just like kick a ball around and pretending to be hurt? Shouts to Teen Titans, who I think first pointed that out. Let's put an electric fence around the barrier. That'll make people watch.
So this counterpick for game two for Unknown, taking it to town. I definitely agree with this counterpick. It gives him a little more time to extend his combos. He doesn't really have to play neutral. It can open up his punish game a lot more. And there's one thing I know about Unknown is that he's very adaptive when he plays.
He's one of the most adaptive players I've ever met.
He's very cerebral. You can even just see in the way he carries himself. And that's a zero to death.
Wow.
Looking like the trailer for Simon Belmont right now. Luigi done. He's over. Soul took. Taken, I should say.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah, Unknown, I don't know how much you've watched of him. He is proficient at the footstool combos.
He's a style guy.
I've seen him do it like 3 times in a row in bracket once.
Stylish young man, for sure.
For sure, yeah. Definitely a crowd pleaser in terms of his Sheik.
Absolutely. And I like that. I like
the neutral air landing instead. So many other Luigis would have gone for a back air. I know, because I play Luigi, and that's what I would have done in that situation.
Sometimes.
808 already knew better than me. Sinking down with a neutral air instead, knowing that the hitbox is big enough to land at that percent off of a reverse up air right there.
Sometimes the
just getting even more damage.
The big green button's all you need sometimes.
I'm pretty sure that's how like Sakurai designed Luigi. It's just like, okay, he's green. That's gonna make kids want to press the green button. So when kids press the green button, let's make sure they have a good time and they win.
Oh, and got a little sink. He didn't jump, but he's dead. Yeah.
That's just one of those awkward moments with Luigi when you don't have your jump off stage, you're down a stock, you don't know what else to do, you see the opportunity for the Drano, and you don't know, you don't really know what else to do, and think to yourself, okay, maybe if I just really, really channel my inner Elegant, I will be able to do this and live and make it back, but nobody really does what
he does. Those fingers aren't power enough, dude.
Unless you're Elegant or Con-Con, you can't do that and you'll make it back.
You need to literally gyrate your hands.
Yeah.
You have to like vibrate at high speed, it's ridiculous. But Unknown, he was a little, I think, apprehensive that very first game on his punish game, but I think now he realizes he can just go ape on him. He can just push the punish as far as he can without having to worry about Luigi mashing the ape button, because he only started doing it, 808 only started doing that the last game. Wasn't really too, like, liberal with the nair.
Yeah.
And I think that's what opened up Unknown's punish game a lot more, because Luigi can interrupt, and I think a lot of people are scared of pressing buttons against Sheik, because once you press that button, Sheik can immediately punish. No problem.
For sure, which is part of why I personally feel this matchup is not very good, because Luigi, at his core, is definitely a button-pressing character. I mean, you can play him quite patiently, but against Sheik, how much of that is going to really be effective?
Exactly.
You press buttons, you whiff punish against Sheik, you're going to eat so much damage for it, you're going to get grabbed, you're going to deal with her oppressive neutral, and then you decide to be a little patient instead? She can needle camp. And then what is Luigi going to do about that? Like, he's going to jump at you? His airspeed is terrible.
Did you see that reaction? He was in the corner. He knew he was about to grab, so Ryan rolled behind him to get the grab.
Mm.
He knew he was about to get, like, stuffed out with an aerial or something, so right as 808 pressed a button, he just hit that roll to the ledge. It allowed him to get that back and open up his punish. He loves going for that, too. He loves going for the boost to get the hit in. I mean, I don't blame you. You got a character that has to do a lot of legwork to get that kill.
Mm-hmm. Wow. I agree. You know, I mean, it's definitely a lot of work to be able to get that kill on Luigi.
Oof.
Luigi mains only really one thing, and it's pretty damn disgusting.
Sometimes you just gotta bust a nut real quick.
Oh my god.
A Deku nut? I'm not. What are you talking about?
Yeah, no, that you were talking about a Deku nut. You're right. I mean, I think we have items turned off, so I don't know why we've been talking about Deku nuts, but yeah.
He's got it right there, though.
He's got it. Yeah, baby. He's got it.
Dear Lord.
Unknown, still with the lead.
It's looking a bit. I don't know about this counter.
That's going to kill.
For 808, because I feel like the tilting hurts Luigi a little bit more, because this stage really assists in whiff punishing quite a bit, and I'm thinking 808 wants to use that to advantage. But again, you're playing against whiff punish the character.
I think maybe he might feel that, like, approaching with forward air for Sheik might be a little bit harder due to the platform layout.
You can't space it as safely.
Yeah, yeah.
Given the tilting and the platform layout, you're taking a slight risk by doing that.
Or maybe 808 is just doing the scrub option, just like, hey, I hope he messes up his recovery.
I hope not. I wouldn't want to call anybody scrub right away.
Usually people in top 48 don't pick Lylat hoping that they just kill themselves.
That's true.
But you never know.
Never know. It happened to me.
And that wouldn't even really be effective against Sheik. She grabs the ledge from like a mile away.
She's good. She's got the wrap ring around her gloves. She's got that monster grip.
For sure.
Hey, okay, I like that a lot. He went for it, but I don't know what mitigating. I think he just didn't wait enough for it.
Yeah, I think he expected him to drift back for some reason, and Unknown just reading that wrong.
My man is not hesitating to throw those diamonds out real quick. All right.
Wow, that was flashy.
Cool. I like that a lot. I love doing that.
That was really so technical.
Cool. It's really cool.
Talk about more technical characters.
You hit it the last frame of your dash off the stage, so when you initiate it, you're able to control all your momentum. It looks so slick as well. 808 has to be really careful now with his landings. He's dwindling into those crazy percentages, and Unknown really hasn't been giving him any opportunities to go for anything explosive like an up B. And Unknown, I think, has been playing this matchup a lot better compared to the first two games. He just hasn't been overcommitting. My man is happy in his relationship.
That is the last thing.
Oh no!
That is the last thing you ever want to do against Luigi, man. I mean, Luigi's playstyle fits his personality. He's very shy. He can't approach women.
Yeah.
He doesn't know how. So you want to try and make him approach you, and he's going to be all awkward about it. And that back air is going to do it. Unknown going up 2-1 over 808 right now. You want to make Luigi approach you. He doesn't know how to talk to girls. He treats them like they're not human. He just doesn't know that all he has to do is just do it. You know, he's awkward when he does it. He's awkward when he approaches, and that's what you want to do. You never want to overcommit against Luigi or press too many buttons against him. And like I say earlier, when I say Luigi is a noob killer, he presses a lot of buttons, or like it seems like he does with all of his combos. It makes lower level players want to like press buttons just as hard because they get overwhelmed.
I want to
point
out
way too good for that at this stage in the game.
I want to point out that 808 has not thrown out a single fireball this entire set. I feel like that would aid him a lot. At least I haven't seen that many. I feel like that would lock down him a little bit more because it seems like he's forcing himself to play this neutral, but Luigi has a projectile as well. Fireball, while not being obviously the greatest projectile, it can still eliminate certain options. Like he'll either be forced to shield or jump over it.
Absolutely. At the very least, if I'm sorry.
Sorry. I think he's keeping himself at way too much of a distance where he's not. I guess maybe he's scared to throw out the fireball in anticipation that maybe he can jump over it and get a free spare in. But I feel like it's a lot better than just standing there and waiting for him to screw up and then open up the punish.
For sure.
But as I say that, he's opening up this game more really nicely.
At the very least, when Sheik starts to needle camp you, then fireballs could maybe be a little bit effective because it will force her to shield.
Yeah.
You know, unless she decides to just eat those damage and just keep mashing B to get those needles out.
It's a good projectile. If you're from a safe enough distance, I don't see how much of a hindrance you can do. The most she can do is get a grab and then hit you a couple of times. Like at these kinds of percentages, like that link will stop working as much. Oh wow, the jab! I love that jab right off of Ledge immediately.
That's such a fantastic option for Luigi.
It comes up so quick, it's one of his best moves.
For sure, Luigi's triple jab. And fun fact, it actually doesn't just match the whole animation, it starts on his shoulder. So if you're a little bit behind Luigi, you will get hit by that jab as well, and it will link into the other two.
Yummy hitboxes.
Yummy, yummy hitboxes. Yummy, dummy hitboxes.
And
bouncing fish? No, just waiting to back air.
He's looking for the back air, but he could not get it. He can press his R button. It's okay.
Yeah, he definitely knows how to press the R button. For sure. He's like, this is on my controller. But which one? He plays with the Pro Controller.
Luigi's Fair also doesn't send you at the craziest angle. Like, it doesn't shoot you out that quickly. It's pretty easy to react to. So good stuff to Brian for really reacting to that.
For sure.
Ooh, the jab. Okay. Now, but Unknown is up once. Another stock. And he could carry him all the way. Okay, no. Okay, but he's still keeping him off stage. And now he's forced to use that.
No more mash. I do believe that was his second down B,
Unknown,
and that is going to be.
It's going off this tournament.
A 3-1 victory for Unknown.
Cassius, 808. This man is going in.
I mean, these guys were up till about. I'm staying with them. They were up till about 2 a.m. practicing.
You guys are staying at Ajax's house, right?
Yes, we are. Yeah. We are staying at Ajax's house.
That's the crib, dude. That's where I stayed last time.
For sure, for sure. But, hey. That is going to do it for us. If you liked my commentary, if you hated it, if you want to tell me some pretty horrible